But accountability, transparency, we tried, all of us, it's gone. We account, parliament, your ministers go in, explain. Here we have press conferences. We are going to have the final one, maybe next week. I didn't realize Monday is already. I was going to say Monday will be the last press conference of this year, where journalists will give an account and ask questions. So transparency and accountability equals trust, I say. So with these thoughts in mind, I would like now to just mention the topics, the headings of issues that we have dealt with. And they are listed, they are too long, I'm not going to bother you with that. But economic and financial sectors. And now you know we have been going through a difficult period. And we have been taking actions like introduction of the national competition policy for Namibia. Revised Namibia cooperative policy, operationalization of Namibia National Single Window Environment. They are listed, but on that sector you will see all that dealing with the financial aspects, tax recovery incentive program, outcome of the 2017-2018 mid-year budget review, and then of course the fishing to bring us money, the allowable catches and so on. Then social sector, Namibia Zero Hunger Strategic Review Report. We have to fight hunger. We have to fight poverty. We don't want any Namibian to go and sleep with hunger. It's still happening. And we have to all pull our efforts together to see to it that it doesn't happen. Revival of the National Food Security and Nutrition Council. Integrated Early Childhood Development Strategic Framework. There are many dealing with addressing social problems. Namibian Arts and Cultural Heritage Policy. We have to revisit that. This culture is just one-sided. When you talk about culture, you're talking about cultural heritage. Are we just talking about German cultural heritage? Where are the other cultural heritages? We have to revive that, we have to look into that daily. Revised language policy for schools in Namibia. Revised national policy on human wildlife conflict management. Big problem, aggravated by drought, of course. So these people were coming, these animals were coming to look for food. In looking for food, they were damaging the other people's food, and also their livelihood. So, comrade Shifeta, are you managing this problem? Are you succeeding? Yeah. Yeah, I see you on TV and helicopter, but are you managing it? I think you have a new helicopter, you put on your uniform, and you look good. But whether you are doing a good job, I don't know. So management, this is a big problem. And that's where the international community must also give us credit. We manage our wildlife, therefore there are too many elephants. Therefore, now they're creating conflict with their neighbors, instead of coexisting. Implementation of the blueprint on wealth distribution and poverty eradication. I don't know why Namibians, some of us, don't want to address the question of inequality. When you talk about inequality, some people campaign, lobby outsiders. I was shocked when I met Her Majesty the Queen. She raised the issue of our deaf Queen. Don't take from rich and give to poor. If you don't do that, you think the poor are going to sit there forever and suffer? We are discussing the issue of, in an orderly, legal way, patiently waiting for 27 years, and say now that we have lived together, we have established now some kind of rapport, that we are honest, we must hold hands as Namibians. We politicians have proved beyond any doubt that we regard all Namibians as Namibians, children of Namibian house. But you cannot live in that house if some are having all the benefits and others are not. Nor are we saying let's be irresponsible and grab from others. We say let's hold hands and see how we can address this problem. It cannot be maintained for a long time. Let's face it. So let's please hold hands. We are going to talk about NEAR very soon. Let's come prepared. We've got all the inputs. All protective, of course, some of them trying to protect what some people already have. But since we're involving them in the spirit of Harambe, we're going to hold hands and pull in the same direction to maintain our peace and unity. There's going to be children living in the same house. Public service governance. The action plan implements strategies for containing the size of the wage bill in public service. Wage bill is just growing. And we are facing a problem. If you lay off people, you add to those who are already unemployed. We're trying to use what is we can do to, if you become 60 years old, not as a politician, I'm elected, by the way, don't look at me now. But we are saying civil servants, if you reach 60, it's mandatory that you leave. We got permanent secretaries who concocted things that they, the permanent secretaries position. The only thing we can use is attrition. And we must hold hands in that one. When you are reaching the age of 60, when you are in early retirement, to do something else. Go and do business instead of doing business when you are a civil servant, which we are doing. We cannot have a corruption laid down. This could be the way to solve the problem. You are 60, that's the time they are fighting to stay on. So please, help us to reduce the waste. The crisis we are facing financially also is allowing us to look at the wastage, how we are wasting money in civil service, in the government. Sometimes I could say it's like floating your salaries. I mean, floating your money, huh? So that they can find equilibrium to bank it at proper level. The same is true with maybe what we are doing. It's a crisis period, but crisis will provide solutions. And definitely we are finding wastage, banking of contracts. These are the things we are addressing. We address them still. Very painful for those who maybe have already promised to get some $1 million. We understand it's tough. So maybe already, but some people are paying a bit in advance. Now once you are given money already, you must deliver. And people are getting angry when you cancel the contracts or projects. You are angry because you already given money in advance. And the promise that I will deliver, don't worry. And people are asking you to deliver, now you are getting angry when you are canceling the contract, projects. some are overcharged. You cannot tell me that the project starts with 3 billion. It's going to be 7 billion. What happened? And we always join the hands and clap and say, Viva! We are now working in Namibia, in Swakopmund, to stop corruption. Instead of doing it and looking around, and he's talking to my desk too, but how he is corrupt. They tried their best, I'm telling you. We were open cuts. Tried all kinds of things. I was warned by my colleagues. Once you declare your assets, you are going to be targeted. I was warned. But we must fight. We must continue, all of us. Why should we be angry if contracts something which is wrong is being cancelled? And we are saying, let's address it to see how we can save money which we don't have. And have it back again, properly. And that people also understand there is no way of just trying to do things, giving people 1 million or one cent, and you got a contract. So yes, it's going on, it's tough. We're not going to stop. We have also feedback on the implementation of cabinet decisions for the period 1st April 2016 to 31 August 2016. Asset management policy framework. And we have problems. It looks like we are making good progress in health. But now, because of whatever infightings and so on, corruption, we are facing problems. The minister is going to tell us later on what is going on. Some are saying it's a fight between the minister and the permanent secretary. But minister, you are a political head, all of you. How can there be a fight between a permanent secretary and a political head? Then you are failing as a head. No fight between the boss. They are all comrades, but the enemy they are the authority. Debate. Problems from the Prime Minister, if people are fighting, one must go or that day, one day. We cannot have situations. People are always happening in the place, they are just hating each other. They don't even beat each other, apparently, some of them. I'm surprised to hear that. Minister just passed. Feminist in the country do this way and pass. How do you win that? Majority will teach you everything, say hello, good morning. Otherwise, how do you win? Which means you don't even have meetings together. No management meetings, committee meetings, or management meetings. Seniors now coming together. Our ministers, be strong. Otherwise, you're going to have to how can women see this rule? Control you. I'm never going to allow you to control you. They're allowing the women see this to control you. Information and communication technology sector, approval of social media use policy, approval of government communication plan, purchasing of shares from mobile community, we'd like to know about that. Some of them, things are happening. And then we come to regional and international relations, of course. We are following the Arambe pillars, as I'm sure you can see, I'm following them. Was sat attending the meeting of the AU and UN. And while we are there, I think people ought to know why we're in this trouble and looking at praying for someone, I made the base. I made the one look at the airwind by the seat. If you want to go, we'll find Albania. I don't know this, but that is not my way of doing things. But when you are traveling, you think it's an easy thing to buy it. I enjoy it. No. If you want to travel, I can pay my own way and go somewhere else and relax. But I'm going on the stage because I must do it. A comfortable place here. Go and stay in a hotel there in New York, it's a good thing to do. And we don't even live in a hotel, we're not living in apartments. We save money. You don't even realize that. What kind of honesty is there? You leave Waldorf Astoria, where they're asking 10 to 20,000 other prisoners a day. And you go and get the apartment for 1,000 a day. You don't even have a night. You're looking for other excuses. With that, you cut the delegation from 40 to sometimes 60 people, including security. Don't look at it. You make contributions. You work like hell, you make contributions. When you go sleep in a hotel, you are having meetings, starting from 7 up to 7 or 10, addressing scholars, addressing business people. Putting Namibia on the map. Even President Trump said Namibia, he put Namibia on the map. CNN and them who didn't like him put it on their own for weeks. And Namibia became popular. Yes, there were many jokes. But that meeting, that Namibia thing put us for nearly all over the world. Again, on the map. So meet people like President Trump and they talk to you about Namibia and you discuss. I discovered you as I told you, you were in Namibia once, you said, yeah, it's a good country. And I said, your children too, who has come to hand here, yes, yeah, it's a good country. You start the conversation. Whether you like what the president said, President Trump is the American president. And you are recognized by those people talking to them, you're wasting sexual money. But it's your job as a first citizen and a diplomat to put Namibia on the map, which we are doing. Then, integration of Africa. We cannot avoid it. The part and parcel of Africa. And Africa will always be suffering if we do not integrate. Firstly, at social economic level. And I announced as a Pan-Africanist, and some of this may be sitting on it, now that Africans can come to Namibia for what visa requires, diplomatic, official passport. That's about 2 years ago. They're sitting on it. And others can get visa at the airport. It has to be just walk in, you are going to be scrutinized. Criminals must not stop you from doing what is right to do, to move around. Arrest the criminals. I don't punish the others who are not criminals. Either we are part of Africa or we are not. Make up your mind. I'm an African. And I think you are also trying to be against Africans. There are criminals, yes. Deal with the criminals. Arrest them. But don't harass others. Some even, we live in their countries. I don't know whether we were angels when we were living in those countries. I don't know. So, either we are Pan Africanist or we are not. But definitely, Africa is our country. Like Namibia is our country. Then we have some bills that we pass. I may be a property practitioner's bill, amendment bill of wildlife control products and trade act, Namibia Post and telecommunications holding, mental health bills, prevention and combating of torture bill. While we are on torture, slavery, can you believe slavery in Libya? Africans being enslaved. I'm glad the Minister already issued a statement to condemn. That's very good. What are we becoming? Slavery in is more than time. And also you can ask a question, why are these people running through Libya to go to Europe? Governance question at home. Peace missing at home. So good governance that we're enjoying here. Don't take it for granted, by the way. Many of you do. Maintaining peace that people can move around freely in this country. So that nobody can run away to be in Libya trying to cross. So they're running away from here. Namibians, even during struggle, whenever there's a swap of internet, all those were under my control in America. Controlled. Patriotic. Ask Bumba. Yes. But some Africans go, they don't want to come back. We are allowed to have green cards, we are refusing that. That is becoming very effective to being an American citizen. Refusing. People are dying to get green cards. Some of us are married to Americans for 3 years who could become a citizen. We refuse. We didn't even countenance that kind of a possibility. Congratulations. And people are running out of their countries because the conditions are not good. And any country can be put in a mess. So we value the peace we are enjoying. It's boring. I keep on saying peace is boring. No action. No doing, doing. We're used to those things. So we're missing in transact. But peace is boring. But count your blessings, my dear comrades. These policy initiatives are informed and guided by the major policy documents, Vision 2030, National Development Plans, Swapo Party Election Manifesto 2014, and the Harambe Prosperity Plan to fast track all of them of my administration. I would like to thank all of you together with your technical staff in your respective ministries for the effort you have put into conceiving, formulating, and actualizing this policy initiative. Through your laudable endeavors, you have given further credence to the Harambe spirit. As a Swapo Party government, we have made a promise to the Namibian people through our manifesto, and our promise is very clear, to deliver prosperity by improving the quality of life of all, not some, of all Namibians. On the evidence provided by this year's cabinet meetings, I'm confident that we have not wavered on this promise. Like any noble cause, challenges and obstacles will always lead us the path to success. But together, we have what it takes to persevere, overcome, and succeed. As the saying goes, and I quote, we are not defined by our challenges, but lifted up by them. As we prepare to draw the curtain on 2017, I encourage all of you to ponder this statement I just quoted. Don't be defined by the challenges you face, but be lifted up by them. The Swakopmund Party government will not be defined by the challenges it faces, but it will be lifted up by them. So I conclude my statement for this last cabinet meeting of the year. Let me wish all of you a peaceful and joyful festive season. That also include all of you who are sitting here, journalists. Many of you are part of us. Brigitte, you are part of us. Always coming here, being disappointed by our answers, but still you are part of us. So this wish is also extended to all of you. When you travel, all of you travel and arrive safe at your respective destinations. Get some good rest, all of you, even the journalists. Good rest, because next year is the year of reckoning. Next year is a year of reckoning. You know, the Bible is a year of judgment. Reckoning. Therefore, I wish all of you in advance, Merry Christmas and a happy, prosperous New Year's, so that you can come back fresh, dedicated, and face the year of reckoning. Go and check out the word reckoning, both from biblical concept and also the other one. With that, I would like to thank you and thank our visitors to peacefully leave the chambers so that we can start our last fire. Thank you.